I wanted to talk. It's still early in the morning, so I gotta be kind of quiet. I'm eating cereal, but healthy cereal. I want to talk about negative people and how you should stay the fuck away from them. I live with negative people. Then go away from them. Go to a church, go to a bookstore, go somewhere where they aren't. Be in a environment that you want to attract. So yesterday, I don't usually get to see my friends anymore because they have different lives than I do. When I used to hang out with my friends, we would complain about life, listen to loud music, loud angry music, complain about other people, complain that the world's not fair, and play video games and watch TV together. Sounds good, right? It's not. All those things are a waste of life, energy, and time. When I went to my friend's house yesterday, since I've changed so much in the last year, the past 3 years, but mostly the past year, I noticed that my friends haven't changed at all. They're still in their loop. They're still in their continuous, it's that person's fault. It's this person's fault. I'm just gonna waste money on video games. I'm just gonna. And it's okay if you like that. It's just you won't get anywhere in life.
My gosh, so trendy!
My friend, I won't say his name, has always been paranoid. Always. But I just listen to him. I hear him out. I hear out what he thinks. And I don't tell you can't think that way. That's not the right way to think. I don't do that anymore. I used to, but I don't anymore. I like those friends because they're very intuitive, but they make bad decisions. I don't like the making bad decisions part. It's just, I need friends that make good decisions all the time and have a positive outlook on life and want to succeed. The problem with the people I was with yesterday, my old friends, mostly only one of them, is too focused on the negative. It's good to be a realist and notice the bad things that are happening in the world, but when you constantly just go on Google and you constantly look up the negative, your life will be negative forever.
But see, it's about you feeling guilty, and now the government will represent Mother Earth, and she'll decide who starves and who lives. So you need to feel guilty and live real poor. We're going to genetically engineer and dump all the stuff that hurt the Earth. It's just humans that are bad, period, because this system is of the spirit that hates humanity.
You need to change. You need to look at the positive. I was so in the loop of the world's gonna end. I'm gonna sell all my money now. I'm gonna sell all my things. Everything's hopeless. The world's over. If you think that way, you're fucked. You're fucked mentally. You're fucked psychologically. The reason the government does those things is to scare you. Blah. If that hasn't dawned on you yet, you need to go outside more and slap yourself in the face and say, hey, wait. I'm fucking brainwashed. Why do I listen to subliminals? It's because I want to improve my subconscious. I want to improve my outlook on life. I want to improve my YouTube channel. I had a dream last night, and the reason I had it was because of my mom. It was because of a friend that said a certain thing when I was at his house. He said, because he gets mad easily, so he's a life path of eight. What do you expect? So when he doesn't get his way, he kind of insults you or gets mad and you kind of just ignore it because you're like, it doesn't affect my life. But it actually does. When you hang out with negative friends, you'll have a negative life. So I'm going to make new friends. It's hard for me because I've known this person for 6 years now. I won't ever forget him, but I am going to make new positive friends. The dream last night was me wandering off through a movie theater. I'm staying on track. Wandering off through a movie theater, going into random movie screenings and talking to people, but not doing anything. Then eventually I went into an arcade and I wandered around, wandering off, wandering, not really getting anywhere. And then my family walked away from me and they were some other place. And I won't forget what my mom said. She called me while she was in the theater and said, "This movie sucks. Everything sucks." And when I woke up, I had to look up that stuff. So when I woke up, I realized that one, my subconscious was adapting to the new DNA mutation subliminal. It sometimes does that. Sometimes your subconscious will have negative dreams because your subconscious is getting used to those new subliminals, if you didn't know that. But also, the thing that my friend said that day was that YouTube's not a job. YouTube doesn't make you any money. He said that because I rejected working with him as a security guard. What sounds better, expressing yourself on YouTube while your foot is messed up, or becoming a security guard while you have a messed up foot and walking for 12 hours a day? That is horrible. That is a terrible, terrible job. Why would I ever want that? Anyone can get a guard card. Anyone. If you have $200, you can get a guard card, and then you can become a security guard. There's no real background check. There's a test that's so easy to pass. I think the worst advice you can give anyone, whether you're a friend, a parent, a babysitter, anything, is you need a job. You just don't have to like it, as long as it pays the bills. That is the mindset of a loser. And I truly mean that. That is a mindset of a loser. If you're not using that money that you work to make more money, you're a loser.
And my mom would say,
well, then you're going to be stuck in the loop of doing what you do and never succeeding. You're never going to succeed. You'll never be remembered. You'll die and people will forget who you, if you ever existed. The point in this life to me is to be remembered, whether it's for something good or something bad. I want to be remembered. I want my name to be written in books, which it will. Let me not get off topic. I don't want to get off topic. Point being is when we were in the car, my mom said, "Well, he's kind of right. YouTube isn't a job." And that is the negative mindset. When you say things like, it doesn't matter if you're happy with your job, it just pays the bills. It's like, that's a negative mindset. You're not going anywhere in life. You're buying PlayStation 4s. You're playing video games all day when you're not working. You're sitting on your ass. You're getting fat. You're eating unhealthy foods. You're failing. You're failing in life. And if my friend is watching this, take this advice and do the things I'm saying. Fix your life. Instead of complain about other people, argue with people, play video games all day, work all night. That's terrible life. It's a horrible life. Be paranoid all the time. Horrible life. At least with me, I have goals. I'm not constantly paranoid about the government raiding all of us. The reason the government and the reason the news and the media tells us these things, one nation will say, "We're going to fight you. We're going to use nukes on you." It's to scare the paranoid people. Easy as that. I used to be one of those. Also, YouTube doesn't pay a lot when you first start out. It doesn't. That's just a fact. That is why, instead of saying, "I'm not making any money from this, this is just a hobby," that's the thing. It starts off as a job, a hobby mixed with a job. But if you just consider YouTube a hobby and that's it, and you never monetize or make money off of it, yeah, it won't be a job. But if you're spending most of the day editing videos, putting your time in, do you think PewDiePie just makes a video and just does it for a hobby? He makes $8 million a year or more. And yet, and Leafy makes about $800,000 a year. And yet, people around me say that YouTube isn't a job. Yesterday, I called Apple. I called Apple because I was going to ask about a computer and modifying it. And I met the nicest guy on the phone for Apple Geniuses. And he said, because he asked what business I am, because you can get a discount on a computer if you own a business. So I told him the truth. I said, "I'm a YouTuber and I'm an Instagrammer. And he said, "Okay, those are considered jobs." And I'm like, see, the problem is with some people, is that they don't think that social media is a job. Social media, I would have to say, is a bigger job than being a security guard. It takes more time, unless you know how to automate it, to do all that stuff. Me, I spent 5 hours making an animation. That is more tiring than doing a security job and hating your life. Fuck that. My friend's other friend, which I get along with a lot, he's really, really nice. Yesterday, he lives with his mother. He's over the age of 25, I believe. I think he didn't tell me his, he wouldn't tell me his age. And why? I used to complain about living with my mom. I said, this isn't fair. This woman's mean to me. Stop complaining. You're living in their house. I never understood that saying. You're living in my house. You have to follow my rules. I never got that. When you think about it, that person actually does care about you if they're letting you live in their house and survive. Your job is to get out of that house and live in your own house. That's what I'm doing. The difference between me and my friend is that he sees no hope. He doesn't see hope. And the people that don't see any hope in the world and say everyone's just going to die, we're all going to go to heaven, that's the wrong way of thinking. My mom would say, thanks? Exactly, it isn't. And that's why those people will never be remembered and no one will ever care about them except their maybe inner circle of their family. I've learned in the past year that complainers get nothing. They have a basic life and that's it. No one likes a basic life. People, here's the thing that people do. They say, yeah, I'm fine with my life. I like this. But deep down in their subconscious, in their minds, they say, I really want money. I want to be rich. Yet they don't think about how. They don't think about what they're currently doing and what it's doing to prevent them from becoming rich. You make your reality. That's why you don't have to be Christian to have faith. You can have faith in yourself and not be Christian or Catholic or some religion with rules. You don't need any rules. Half the people who are Catholic or Christian that go to church, they don't follow those rules. They may follow some of them, but they don't follow all of them. Why? Because what they like is the motivated, nice people around them. That's kind of why I like church get-togethers and gatherings. Everyone's nice to everyone. There isn't some person making fun of another person. They're nice to each other, and they don't talk about God. The funny thing about churches is that they don't talk about God very much. They will speak about God, but they won't really, it won't be all about God. Churches are more for monetizing off people, like making money off people. But the point being is people are nice to each other. Honestly, I only do it to be around positive people. My grandparents may be passive aggressive, but they're still positive. My grandma does everything for everyone. She makes blankets for people. She donates. She does everything to help other people. Because what you put out, you get back. This is how motivated I am. When I woke up from that dream and I felt a little uneasy, unmotivated, I listened to 5 motivational videos in the course of an hour. And I felt rejuvenated. I felt great. I forgot what my friend said, how YouTube wasn't a job. Because I said, my YouTube account's starting to make me more money. The thing with unmotivated people is they give up too easily. Even my friend's friend said, are you sure it's going to be this year when the world's going to end? And I was just in me, I was, ha, ha, ha. I was laughing like crazy because I'm like, one, America, the USA, is the world's superpower. They are incredibly strong. 2, Russia and Trump and China, there are elites in every country. The point of scaring the US people is to keep them unenlightened. They don't want people to join the 1%. So they scare us. I don't fall for that fright, that fear anymore. I'm smarter, I'm enlightened, I'm motivated, I'm determined. Hell, up there, I printed up the exact computer I'm going to buy, and I put it all the way at the top, because the psychological thing of the human mind is that anything that's above you, this truly works, anything that's above you. I have three motivational pictures right here, and the fourth one on top is the computer. It shows the price, it shows everything. And what does that do? It programs you. When something is above you, especially taller than you, you look up at it and make that your first thing that you're going to do. You don't do it. Your conscious mind doesn't do it. Your subconscious mind does it. It happens on a subconscious level. You're not going to run out and go buy a computer and have no money. But every time you walk in your room and you see that, it's going to encourage you to save money. It really works. If you're a terrible person at saving money, try it. Just try it. Put something you really, really, really want up above you on the wall. And every time you walk into your room. I love knowing how the human mind works. Why people say the things they do. Why people do the things they do. A depressed person will always try to bring you down to their level. Never. And I'm going to end it here. Never let a depressed person bring you down to their depression. You are better than them. And the world's not going to end this year. Don't stop worrying.
Crushing.